Hey everybody, welcome back. We're doing another Marvel Future Revolution video. We're gonna be talking about Omega cards. Are they the ones that you really need to focus on as far as your stats go? I did a couple other videos related to this type of topic where I got some spreadsheets in there. I'm not gonna go into depth like I did there. I will touch it for a second just so we can remind ourselves of a couple things. But I had some nice pulls lately, and I think I'm gonna do maybe some other ones. We'll see if I have to scratch that itch to go get it. So, anyway, appreciate you guys stopping by. Check the Discord link out if you wanna, you know, follow along for more content, community discussions, stuff like that. Hammer down like buttons, notification bells, subscription buttons if you like. Appreciate that as always. And let's go have this conversation.
Wolverthor!
Okie doke. So, you know, I mentioned that I've opened some recently, and I wanted to share with some folks. So I finally got my first two special cards. I got this Amazing Spider-Man one, and obviously I brought it up to six. And I got this Doctor Strange one. The Spider-Man one, sadly, has some terrible bonus stats on it. I mean, I guess... You know, when I was doing some super villain damage stuff with Dormammu, I was playing with some Alliance mates, and I was like, oh, I don't think I can take this. And because a really strong, powerful Alliance mate was there, and another gamer we know in the game who I knew was strong as well. I was like, I can't beat the two of you guys, and I don't want to get, you know, I want to make sure I get a good score on Dormammu. And I just like, you know what, I'm going to do it. I'm going to stay anyway. And I like... It did insanely well. So I was kind of like, all right, these bonus stats on these specials are really nice. Now, I am totally going to re-roll this because just guard damage decrease, all these. I'm just like, all right, the exclusive stat was at least solid. I would have preferred decrease, but, you know, whatever. It's at least okay. It's not, you know, surface to air or something along those lines. So I was pretty happy. And of course, at some point, this is the other one I would love to have is the Black Widow crit damage card. That'd be great. So as I pulled this, I was like, wow. And in the same pull, exact same pull, I got this one. Also PvP damage increase, which I was kind of like, all right. And the Spider-Man was a 4. So I had to build that from a 4 to a 6. This one came as a 5. And I was like, all right, the cooldown decrease is pretty decent. I do like that stat. It's not the accuracy, which I would prefer. Honestly, I hate to say that, but... Right now in game, I really, really need that accuracy. And again, the bonus stats weren't great. And I was like, okay. But the truth is if I roll this one up to 6, which I have not decided if I'm going to do, I've got some pretty nice stats on this thing. Now, I'd love to hear from you guys if you actually think I should roll this up to 6 and why. Don't just say yes. Because I'm a little torn here. And I want to get into some of the card sets here for where we're at. So... Originally, I had this Midgardia 4 set where I was kind of like, okay, I wanted to have all four of that because I like the crit damage buff and the 4 set crit rate bonus because the 4% crit rate bonus isn't bad. And if you go to my hero, I don't have a high crit rate, you know, so it's like, okay, where's my crit rate? Did I pass it? Yeah, it's 38.9%. Ouch. Ouch, 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 ouch. Now, with Widow, obviously I can use my ultimate and go immediately into a crit, right? But I've only got, I mean, if it's in Dimension Duel, I have to wait. And even then, it's like I might get one or, like, if I have two alts in Dimension Duel, that's like mind-blowing. So I typically am not critting there. So for that purpose, you really kind of need it. For stuff like Dark Zone or... You know, just around in a boss or something like that. Yeah, okay, fine, whatever. But I need to get that crit rate up. So that 4%, you know, that can be pretty critical when I'm looking at things, right? So, not that one yet. We'll go to that in a second. So, you know, I'm going, okay, I'm losing 4% of my crit rate, right? Now, again, Alliance mate, shout out to Dirk here on this, is we were talking about this set, this Hydra Empire set. And I think it was the first two cards, if I remember correctly. The first one's attack, and these are two set bonuses for attack as well. And this one is another crit damage, where's more attack. So I started looking, thinking like, huh, maybe I can go, you know, get, and now this is a six star card there. So I start thinking about maybe I can find something with crit rate on it with these two, you know, just as a, you know, if I can get an attack and maybe a crit rate on something, maybe I can get that. You know, you look at the special cards. Let's go look at these real quick. So Captain America, again, attack, not bad. Captain Marvel, you've got, I skip it all. I'm like, PvP damage increase. I'm like, eh, we already talked about Spider-Man. We talked about Widow, but that's damage again. That's the one I really want. So it's kind of like, okay, an Iron Man card, villain damage, no. Already got that Doctor Strange. Here's another Doctor Strange, Doctor Villain, or Super Villain damage decrease, no. Star-Lord, which I ended up getting as well, also an attack. I'll show you that in a second. And then we've got the Storm, right? So all of these special cards, I'm not seeing any crit rate on them. So I'm really stuck with a situation where I have to start looking for other cards, you know, and maybe find stuff. And it's kind of like, okay, what do I actually want to do? Where are these crit rate cards at? That's what I want to get, right? So you're seeing all these stats pop up. It's like, and then so I'll find something. But that's just crit rate, okay? I mentioned that I had that Star-Lord. Where is he at? So I ended up pulling this one too. Surface-to-air damage. Oh, my Lord. Now, Netmarble did mention that they might give us ways to do some stuff with these cards. So I'm going to hold on to this because a special is rare. But that hurt, you know what I mean? And that's where it's like, okay, that can really mess up your hard deck. I know you guys know that, but it's kind of like, okay. So my equip sets now I'm looking at, so I've got these two. I've got Defense Pierce, and Defense Pierce is all the rage at the moment. And we're still trying to figure out what's going on with the stats. I got a good roll with a 4 on that 6. The bonus stat, an additional Defense Pierce, and my Vote Loki card, which is PvP damage decrease. Max damage rate, don't love that, but it's not bad. The other two cards I like to run at the moment, which I might reconsider, is this Future Imperfect with the ultimate gauge recovery. You know, it's got some more Defense Pierce on it, which is nice. Total damage stat, which is and here we go. So this is the card again that, you know, crit rate. So this one I do like. It's got a lot of total damage on it, and it is my rare card at the moment. Or I'm sorry. I've got it up to a 6-star at the moment. You know, these stats, I'm kind of like, okay. So now as you look at all these things, it's like all lots of stats here, right? So I once mentioned before that I have got a spreadsheet that I put together that I did in a different video that, you know, kind of shows the stats that you get from different, you know, aspects of the game, right? So don't mind the color too much here. I'll zoom in some here. So with the way this is set up, is I've got all the stats on the left-hand side, and this was back on September, you know, a few weeks ago now, and the different categories of where you get, you know, stats from, right? So for me, at this point in time, I entered the stat that I had, and then how much of that stat was from that category. So you can see, like, attack, it was really all about, you know, my costume and my battle badge. You know, maybe it'll go up with my Spider-Man card. So I started looking at these things, and it's like, okay, what is really, you know, the ones where I'm like really pulling a lot of stuff? And the one where you're looking at is you want to see the, you know, the good here is, you know, the purple, there's some teal and some green. Those are the best ones you want to see. Red's pretty low. So as I was looking at Omega cards at this time, they were pretty low, but then, you know, all gauge recovery, again, because of my choice, I was like, okay. Again, crit rate percent was a lot. 41%. My crit damage was a lot. That was 20% of what I was looking at here. Defense Pierce, clearly, if that's the stat that everyone's kind of looking for, you know, there are some sets for, you know, Iron Man. I think the Dark Domain one has Defense Pierce as one of the set bonuses. Total damage, again, that was just random stats in there. PvP damage increase. A lot of these ones down here, you know, are those exclusive stats that you get from your cards. So it's like, these Omega cards are really, really, and I know this goes without saying, but they're like crazy important. And it's an easy way to get high stats. So jumping back over in game, I'm sitting here going, what can I do to get these improved? Now, now this is the hard part where it's like, you know, I've got a lot of these are already rare cards that you can see in here. Some of these, I don't like to, you know, crunch these because they're rare, and maybe I'll need them on somebody. I don't know. Maybe the way the game works later, maybe I want to re-roll this one up here where I have, because I have that one here. It's Defense Pierce. Maybe at some point I need something else. I don't know. So I'm kind of keeping these just in case, so I don't have a lot of things to crunch. So this is one of the things I want to throw in, and I did this in one of my beginner series videos, is make sure that you do your dailies. Make sure that you go get all of your most wanted, your most wanted bosses. Make sure you get in a dark zone and get those cards. You know, I'm in the process of moving across country. It's part of the reason why I'm not getting videos out every day is, and I could, my dark zone last night, I threw my Spider-Man for like 30 minutes just to try to get some cards. And I wasn't even really paying attention very much. I was just like, I know I was dying a lot, but even if you can do that, definitely do that. And I was doing it with my Alliance. So I knew, you know, I could go through there and get some stuff right now. You know, stuff like this, HP, no. So anyway, get your cards, make sure that you do not miss them. That sort of thing is definitely critical. And find these card sets that you think you want, you know, and I'm not here to tell you, sorry if that's what you came here for, which ones to go get, right? I don't want to do that. You know, you can find some stuff on here and just, but this is all it takes is going through here and finding these sort of cards and seeing what exact ones that you want. And I highly suggest doing this because you want to find the ones that you need for your character. And some like Xander is like, no, I'm not doing any of this. There is one that, I was a bit surprised. I don't see it at the moment. I think this is the set. So this one, you get some defense pierce from MODOK. And is it this Ultron one? Yeah, that Ultron one is pretty solid too. So those, excuse me, those two are pretty good. You know, if you're trying to get more defense pierce and, you know, get some high crit damage, those are solid. These two I wouldn't mess with. You know, it's like, I don't really need that. You know, anybody who wants to do like speed runs on villains or something like that, you can certainly go get that. The Doctor Strange card, is this the one that, yeah, this is the one, like, honestly, I love. The problem with it is that the two set bonus on this is HP. So even if one of these are something I really wanted, I don't care. I really don't. And right now you can see none of these stats that are popping up, I care about at all. This is really like heavy into defense supervillain stuff. So this one's just sitting here like, oh, I want, but I need accuracy rate so bad. So I'm trying to improve some badges on that stuff like that. But to end this video, I did one. The reason I got those is I just did some draws. So I'm going to do one draw before I get out of here. Unless I get, like I mentioned, I want to scratch that itch. So, you know, go in here, draws, and I'm saving up some costumes. Now these draw chances are increased. I normally don't like to do this. So it's kind of like, okay, so, you know, where is my, you know, ones that they're not increased, right? So because I don't need, you know, this is the banner, the draw rate's increased. I don't need or want any of these. Okay, this one, yeah, maybe I guess I'd take it. But if I didn't, you know, I'm looking at these over here, right? And those are the ones I really want. I'd love another Spider-Man. Well, actually, I don't want a Spider-Man, but I'd love, love, love that card. So, so you come in here, you get the Alliance loyalty. So I'm just going to do this draw. We'll see what we get and keep our fingers crossed. And this is how we're going to end the video with. We're going to spend some 1800 crystals here, see what happens. And now technically there is a way this animate, this actually can show what will run right here. If I get anything, Captain America shield. No, I got trash. So normally, now this is like, do I need to scratch that itch again? I might need to do one more. So because that was not, I knew I didn't get anything good. Well, unless it's wrong. Yeah, see, these are just rare. So now these are the draw chance increased. So that's why there was just a little bit hesitant. And this is a rare. So these aren't good cards, but they are fodder. And you can see there's a bunch of 3-stars here that I can use to throw into the pot here. This one again, you know, these are just, this is fodder, right? So we're going to do one more because I have to scratch that itch. And you guys got to keep your fingers crossed for me. Keep your fingers crossed. Give me something good. Give me something good. Last one of the day. Come on, Groot. Show me something good. Give me a Captain America shield. Oh, again, nothing. So anyway, that's where sometimes the itch scratching, it's just like, stop while you're ahead. So I'm done here. Nothing good. But these are going to be 3 rares, right? So a 4-star rare, draw chance increased here with this guy. Again, don't really care about stuff like that. Another rare. This is the situation where sometimes do I need to consider crunching those, right? And be like, and then, hey, PvP damage increase, right? But I don't want this card. I think I even have several of these. So anyway, I appreciate you guys stopping by. Get your Omega cards built up. They are critical. The specials help you so much. It's definitely changed what I've done in game a bit. Able to kill some people a little higher. Brought my attack up, and I need to keep refining things. They're hard to get, so don't go crazy necessarily. Play within your means. You saw I had about 12,000 crystals, so I was like, I could do that and still get my daily stuff done, and it was no big deal. So like I mentioned, Discord link in the description below. Hammer down the like button, click the notification bell, and of course subscribe. We'd appreciate you doing that, and follow along with content in the future. And until next time, hope you have a wonderful day.